I hope that my voice is heard as a wisp of flame in an otherwise colorless universe of unseen wilderness. To describe my vision, fractured voices crying out to be seen, emerging like paintings in a world where only shadows occur, but without their bodies. Yet, given color and form interchangeably from this flame itself. And yet, it would seem, however, they are only ever in their process of breaking, hanging, as if it were, or lolling, from mouths, these frames, my own desires, greediness, or gateways, tongues, and there can be no transgression. Transhumance awaits the eyes of the immortal like its flesh, a vista of death, whom it has failed completely elsewhere in the suddenly torn realm of the eternal. It is a metaphysical truth that all nature would begin to lament if it were endowed with language. Speechlessness, that is the great sorrow of nature. Even where there is only a rustling of plants, in it there is always a lament. Because she is mute, nature mourns. The sadness of nature makes her mute. Dreams is over. Over thin lands, the sky disguises them, this time in the listener's heart, as it stretches to the open trees and to the forests that stretch.